the Lord, he reigns. Oh, he reigns.
He reigns. He reigns. We give glory to the Lord. Oh, we give glory. We give glory to the Lord. He reigns. We give glory to the Lord. He reigns. Oh, he reigns. He reigns. He reigns. We give glory to the Lord. In my language, why are you
reigning in life and reigning in death. Our God reigns. Do we agree that our God reigns? I want us, of us, before I pray, I want us to lift up our voice and begin to magnify this God that reigns, the giver of life, the creator of the heavens and the earth. There is no God like our God. He is the Ancient of Days, the beginning and the end, the Alpha and Omega. I want you to just lift up your voice and give him some worship. He's worthy of praise. He's worthy of honor. He's worthy of adoration. Oh, lift up your voice and give him thanks. Father, we give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you adoration. You reign. You reign supreme. There is no God like you. You are forever the same, yesterday, today, and forever. There is none like unto thee. From everlasting to everlasting, you are God. For thou art worthy, O Lord, to receive glory, honor, and power. For thou art created all things, and for thy pleasure they are all well created. So, Lord, we magnify you this afternoon. We exalt you. We bless you. We thank you. We thank you. We say, be thou exalted. Be thou glorified. Be thou magnified. We give you thanks. We give you honor. We give you adoration. For in all things, your word says we should give you thanks. So, we have chosen to give you thanks. We have chosen to give you thanks, irrespective of this circumstance. We choose to give you thanks because that is your will concerning us. We say, blessed be your holy name. You are worthy. Thank you, King of Kings. Thank you, Lord of Lords. Father, we give you praise for this moment. We exalt you. We thank you that life comes from you. For in you we live and move and have our being. And Lord, nothing can separate us from the love of God. Not life, not death, not principalities, not powers. For in all things, your word says we are more than conquerors. And therefore, you have given us victory.
Victory.
You have given us victory.
Amen.
We are victorious because of the resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
For though we die, we live. And Benson is alive. He is well. He is strong. He is healthy. He is whole. Because of the resurrection of Jesus. So we thank you for the sacrifice of your Son. And because of the resurrection, we have hope for tomorrow. Because we know that your word is true. You are a faithful God. So Lord, we thank you for the family. Amen. We ask that your grace will abound towards them. Amen. You will uphold them by your righteous right hand and show yourself strong on their behalf. Mighty God, comfort them, strengthen them. Amen. Oh Lord, let them lift up their eyes unto you, the author and finisher of their faith. We thank you for giving us this precious gift for 34 years. We are grateful. We thank you for the impact he made in his family, in the impact he made in society as a whole. Father, your son came and at 33, he had to go. His impact is still being felt after 2,000 years. Benson's impact will be felt because he led a quality life. And Lord, we are asking that their faith will be strengthened. Oh Lord, strengthen their faith. Strengthen their faith. You told Peter, the devil has desired to sift you like wheat, but I've prayed for you that your faith do not fail. And when you are converted, strengthen your brothers. May they be a comfort to many families. May they be a comfort to people who go through similar situations. May they say that God kept us and God can keep you. May they be a source of hope for many. Thank you for the saints that are gathered here. Thank you for the comfort that they have given. Bless them, O Lord. Anyone who is going through any challenge, I want you to take heart, because this family has taken heart, that the Lord will help you. Father, we sanctify the food that we are going to eat with the precious blood of Jesus. We ask that that food will not be ordinary, but it will be food that will give us strength for the journey ahead. To Elijah, get up and eat, because the journey ahead is long. Mighty God, give us strength for the journey. Give us power for the journey. Grace for the journey. Mighty God, that we will finish our race. That at the end, we will meet Benson again. So that all of us will finish well. None of us will fall by the wayside. That we will be reunited with him. And together, we will worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We give you thanks. We give you praise for how far you brought us. Thank you for the rest that you are going to take care of. At the end of it, the glory, the honor, and the adoration is yours. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen. Thank you for that powerful prayer. So I'm so glad that people that still need seats, so get some extra seats in there. The ushers also love our drinks and stuff. We're going to have some of the tributes which we were able to get to at the church. But we know people are hungry, so for now, let's get some drink, have some snacks, and then we get into some of the trees a little bit later.
Yeah. Thank you. Come on.
that not everybody has seats, so they're trying to bring in some extra chairs, so please just bear with us as we're trying to get that done. There are ushers going around with drinks and some snacks while we wait for the main food. So if you don't have a drink, just feel free to call out to one of the ushers and we'll make sure you get a drink. So if anybody brought a donation that they would like to give to the family, I'd just like to point your attention to the back. If I have the two gentlemen stand up, it's like they're hiding in the corner, but there's two tables at the back for donations. If you want to give anything to the family, they're right at the back. Okay, I'm getting a wave. And also there's t-shirts. Yes, the t-shirts are there. If you want a memorabilia of Benson, a t-shirt as well that you can get at the back. And if you have not signed the remembrance book, this may be a good opportunity just to go and just sign and leave a note, you know, share some memories with the family. As I said earlier, I know people are hungry, it's been a long day, but we will be getting to some of the tributes we were not able to read at the church earlier on. So just enjoy, and again, thank you for being here with us to celebrate the life of Benson. Thank you.
Stand by and take account. Or they're through. Oh, no. Can I guess it's not to let you know that no one be like you. possibility. There's no positivity. Always negativity.
Baby girl, I know but I like the way you Christ. Me get the body that boys if you the tundra. That the whole thing came with that memo than the lumba. Me the best and better crack in the kunsa. Papi that you see was and that you be a me boomba. Yeah. Boys see the so supporting and me swimming jam up on what she be just uniform. Said the cop private in the coach, she be just a backpack. Cause they get the meaning until I'm swimming see the form. For the whole
for your mother like for your body like a big.
I want to marry you, see that me do who prayer was. My member don't give a damn cause it's in the key across. The testimony, the share with a man, yeah, with time. With Samson Jimu, who did look how rap I never size. What do we want? And it no be money, no be high. I'm not compared with it, we do, let me deal the eyes. Finally, now be better, I'm coming like the Holy Ghost. And can then I get to cop high, let me to go. Yeah, it took me so long to get you. They say I can't wait, I will never let you go, me drag.
Thank you. We'd like to welcome each and everyone to the auditorium service center on behalf of the Bonsu family. Yes, that's the Chol sound system. Me, myself, and I am a certified. Yes, of course, the master ceremonies. I'd like to remind each and everyone that if you want to use the tents, at the back, you see the door over there. If you go through that entrance, you find the tents and ladies over there. Also, I'd like to remind each and everyone that at the very back, we have Sir Dave, who is in charge of all the swan. Someone can say, to be a royal, be a person. You have various drinks in your bakery. So we are helping. So over to me, Afrey, Omoa, Musha T-shirts, Christ the King, and me, a Bushina, four name number four Mokwa. All right, Tintino, Mumia, and Yunkakra, and from FAD. About what they are in a program now, they perform for call. At the DJ, they are going.
Thank you.
You have. Okay.
So can I please get your attention? So as you know, this morning at the church, we couldn't get to all the tributes, but there's a very important tribute that we wanted to make sure it was read out, and it's from Judith, who's representing the medical professionals and the team over at Harley Street, where Benson was being taken care of and was going through his medical process and healing. So I'd like to pass it over to Judith. And can we please, please, I know there's a lot going on in the back, but if this is something that we can kindly please get our attention over here. So I'll hand over to Judith for that tribute.
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening.
Mrs. MENSAH-BONSU, it's a great honor for me to be here this evening. I'm going to begin actually by reading a letter from one of our colleagues, which is to Benson, but she couldn't be here, but you all know Liz. Dearest Benson, I am so sad that I am unable to be here with you today, but you are very much in my thoughts. The first time I met you, I was immediately drawn to your charismatic personality. At a time when you were feeling pretty rubbish following your surgery. Even then, you managed to ask me how I was before I could introduce myself to you. That was the man you are. Always thinking of others, kind, considerate, positive, no matter how you were feeling. You had ambitions, hopes, and dreams that I found compelling to listen to. You had the ability to bring everyone you met into your world, captivated by your personality. To many people, your life seemed short, but what you have achieved during your time on Earth is incredible. You brought light when there was darkness, comfort and loyalty to your friends, family, and all of us who met you through your illness. I feel immensely proud and privileged to have known you and maybe helped you in some small way. I am grateful for the time I spent with you. You inspired me and how we laughed over quite mad and silly things. You made memories for me that I will never forget. You touched the hearts of so many people, so evident in the number of friends that are here today. You are very loved by your family and friends, and of all of us would have liked to have had that nursed you, would have liked to have met you under different circumstances. I just want to thank you, Benson, for being you. Without knowing, you gave so much more than you took. The world will never be the same without you in it. My love to you, Liz.
Okay.
That came from the bottom of Liz's heart, because she actually saw Benson two or three times a week, at least, for 8 months. And they did share lots of laughs together. But I'm here with other nurses from Harley Street. So I'm just one. And I say one with caution, because Benson had an innate ability to make each of us, or perhaps I should say all of us, feel that we were the one. Of course, I don't need to tell you that we are all unique, but for all of us here, there is, and only ever will be, one Benson. Despite his suffering, Benson's story was full of love, laughter, charm, mischief, bravery, and business success. Integrity, adventure, sporting achievement, mentorship, and courage. It's often tempting when writing a eulogy to make somebody out to be a saint. If I tried to do that, Benson would laugh. Because what he was real. He was a truly authentic representation of all that is good in humanity. Benson, together with his friends and family, have left us with a moving legacy of life and love. Be More Benson became a catchphrase in my own home. My children, albeit teenagers, well, actually in their 20s, would ask every day when I got home from work, how's Benson today? And I would tell them, and then if I was exasperated with them, or cross even, they'd say, oh, we get it, you want us to be more Benson. And so a new hashtag was born. Of course, Benson found it very funny that his smile and gift of caring for others could spread from his hospital bed vicariously. I know there were a couple of occasions when I left him quite perplexed. Not in a professional sense, you understand, but in a technical sense. I had some information I need to give him on one of his earlier admissions, and I needed to share it with him. He suggested I Dropbox it to him. I looked at him in bemusement and horror. He tried to explain, took my phone, and did it for me. But just imagine his face when I did tell him that I actually had my own Twitter account. He was totally amazed. Somebody who texted with one finger very slowly had managed that. He was impressed. I did confess later that somebody had done it for me. He loved his Twitter family, speaking often of the kindness they showed him by giving him a sense of professional purpose, dignity, and self when he was being robbed of his physical strength by the cancer. This is really important, and actually it's a real gift that Twitter have given or gave to Benson, because it's hard when you're in hospital for months at a time. It was always impressive to us how his friends and cousins wrapped him in a rota of love, accompanying him to appointments and driving him places when he was too unwell to drive himself, or just being there to hold him in love and laughter. All this done with great humour and sensitivity, and often very fancy trainers. When we received an offer of a bed in the inpatient unit, Audrey called Kojo, Pops and Wuffy. Benson was very weak. Should we accept the offer of a bed? Dr. Ellicombe and myself went in to discuss this with Benson. Fiona, our occupational therapist, was holding his hand. Ellicombe gently and carefully explained the bed offer. B took one look at me, stroked my hair and said, no tears, Jay, it's time. And so, with the timely arrival of Benny and Amma, they accompanied Benson as he did a walk of honour around the ward, saying goodbye to everybody. He then got himself onto the stretcher that was ready to take him away with the ambulance crew. However, in an extraordinary moment of laughter and tears, he turned to the ambulance crew and said, you're Arsenal, aren't you? And they sheepishly said, yes. I mean, how did he know? And then, so I said to him, how did you know? And he said, he turned to Benny and Amma and said, we can always suss them out, can't we? And so Audrey accompanied him on the trickiest journey to Trinity. At this point, I would actually like to give a shout out for Trinity Hospice. As those of you who are from this country will know, that that hospices in this country are essentially run by charity. They gave Benson the warmest welcome and cared for him beautifully. Not as beautifully as us, of course, but they did a really good job. And his community nurse, he actually challenged them, because over here you can't usually have chemotherapy when you're in a hospice, but Benson persuaded them. How did he do it? And so he was taken to their hearts, And on my last visit to see Benson, Kojo and Pops were laughing about their trainers, obviously, as they sat holding Bee's hand with Waffy, Audrey and Agnes. Having kept a vigil with Benson throughout the week. Benson taught us all so much. He was a gift as a patient to us, because what we do is actually quite tough at times, but he helped us to help him. And so I'd just like you all to think about the fact that with every grief story, there's a story of love. And sometimes in grief, there is a conflict between the world as we know it having stopped forever, leaving our hearts shattered, and life's insistence that it continue. So we must honour Benson and live beside our sadness, because although death is sad, remembrance is not. And Benson has left a footprint implanted in the minds and hearts that will live and remain with us all forever. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We're just going to keep the tributes going, but before we do that, just please, as a sign of respect, when they are reading the tributes, can we please, just as a sign of respect, just be quiet and listen, just for a short time. That's the, you know, one thing I just ask. Let's just try and keep it really quiet. So at this point, I'm going to call Sally Norma from George Washington University, where, as most of you know, that's Benson's alumni. So let's hear for her as she comes up.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
To the MENSAH-BONSU family, our deepest, deepest condolences. Thank you for the gift of Benson and for having us here today. We all know that Benson had an infectious laugh, a contagious smile, and a unique way to make even a stranger feel like you've known him for years. We also know him as extremely thoughtful, ambitious, and most of all, creative. In a bio that he wrote as a student at GW in 2010, he described himself in the following way, and I quote, "My parents named me Benson, but my peers referred to me as Creative Bonsu. The title reflects my state of mind 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Even my communication possesses creativity. I love to use metaphors. So when people ask me what I do, I tell them I'm the Wolverine of marketing. Since I was 8 years old, I've always been engaged in business and marketing endeavors," he continues. "From selling cups of Kool-Aid in London to consulting with professional athletes and entertainers internationally. At the age of 14, I created an urban lifestyle social network of 4,000 teens in London. The George Washington University School of Business is my laboratory to test my expertise." End of quote. It was at the George Washington University, or GW as we call it, that we had the privilege to see Creative Bonsu in the flesh. On campus, among other things, he was the founder of G Durbin, a music collective for GW students. He played intramural basketball and led countless business-related organizations. He was no doubt a star on campus. When he decided to return to London, he did it with pride, saying, and I quote, "There are millions to be made, innovations to be created, and nations to be dominated. I thank you for being in my life. Let's continue to celebrate the great times." End of quote. When we think of Benson, let us think of the great times, the incredible laughs, the smiles, the fun we shared. Let's also remember the way he inspired us all to be great at everything that we do, and the incredible legacy he started to build before even realizing. Benson, it is an honor to have been blessed with your presence. We at GW know that even though your physical body isn't here, your spirit lives on. We know that you will keep being creative, even in the heavens. We love you, We miss you. We will never forget you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate all of you and your cooperation as well. So, as most of you know, Benson was working at Twitter, so it's only right. Oh, okay, Twitter family can make some noise. And if you have a Twitter account, make some noise. Okay, so at this point, I'm gonna call Emily from Twitter, who's also gonna share a tribute from the Twitter family. Emily, can we hear for Emily as she comes up?
Thanks everyone, and hello, good afternoon. My name is Emily Lanfear, and I had the honor of working closely with Benson during his time at Twitter. I want to start by thanking the MENSAH-BONSU family for giving us an opportunity to share a few words with all of you today about the impact that Benson had on all of us. I speak today on behalf of Benson's Twitter family, many of whom are at the table there in the corner, his colleagues from many teams all around the world who loved, respected, and cared so deeply for him. We have a hashtag we use at Twitter, which says, love who you work with. And we loved Benson. Benson joined Twitter in June of 2020 as our first ever athlete partner manager in the UK. This was a highly coveted role, and we searched far and wide for the perfect candidate. And immediately, as soon as we met Benson, we knew we had the perfect person. He joined us at a time when our offices were closed due to the pandemic, and although for months he didn't meet a single colleague in person, the depth of his relationships, his friendships, his connection with fellow tweets was immense. His presence was truly felt beyond borders. Benson's spirit was known and appreciated far and wide throughout Twitter. His passion, his curiosity, his playfulness, and his contagious energy were all uniquely Twittery, and he had the distinct ability to leave a positive mark on everyone he came into contact with. Wherever we were in the world, Benson's gift was to help us feel more deeply connected through the many moments of joy, laughter, and inspiration we shared with him. Benson created connection and community in everything that he did. Within weeks of joining Twitter, he cemented himself as an active member of Blackbirds, our business resource group for Black tweets and allies. Benson immediately became a cornerstone in the Blackbirds family. He served as a dedicated Blackbirds lead, helping spearhead Blackbirds initiatives across the UK. He was incredibly proud of his Ghanaian heritage and committed to uplifting and helping his community shine wherever and however possible. Benson's energy and passion for life touched us all, and he leaves behind a legacy of authentic passion, love, and togetherness that will forever be a guiding light for Twitter Blackbirds. Benson was also a central figure on our global partners team. His work with his athlete partners drove him and fulfilled him and brought him joy that was so clearly evident by the enthusiasm with which he approached his work. Benson believed passionately in Twitter's unique ability to help athletes tell their stories, and he took tremendous pride in his role in helping them do just that. Every single day, he brought his full self to his work and endeavored tirelessly to not only empower athletes via Twitter, but to also protect the most marginalized and vulnerable among them from online abuse. Benson was a zealous advocate for all things diversity and inclusion within and beyond the sports industry. He dedicated his voice to amplifying, shining a light upon, and lifting others, and he pushed the culture forward at every turn. Benson's sister, Benny, recently remarked, "Twitter was his dream job. Little did we know that God would allow him to live out that dream before passing away." We are forever grateful that Benson found his way to us when he did. He left an indelible mark on his colleagues and on Twitter, both the company and the platform. He inspired us, he made us better, and he made Twitter better. We are honored to have known him, to have worked with him, and to have learned from him, and to have experienced his light. With immense gratitude for the time we shared with Benson, he will continue to be an inspiration to us all. And I'll just add that he is so much so an inspiration that we have a newly renamed room in the Twitter London office, named in Benson's memory, at Creative Bonsu. That will be a forever reminder of his legacy, long lasting, at Twitter. Thank you.
What a great honor. Can we please hear it for Twitter in general? Wow. Wow. So at this point, I'm going to call Kabna and Michael to come up, and then, you know, some of Benson's oldest and dearest to come up and share tribute just before we eat. The food, I've been told, is ready, so, and I know we're hungry. So could we please hear it for Michael and Kabna as they come up as well?
Thank you very much for the opportunity to say a few words about Benson. Thank you to his family for contributing to who he is, because we all loved him for that. So I've known Benson not as long as the majority of you, but he had a massive impact on me personally. We met while I was at the gym, I was banging out my squats, and Benson walked over, asked me how many sets I had to lift to. And we struck up a conversation. And very quickly, it felt like I'd known Benson for a long time. And then Michael, a mutual friend of us, came over and was like, oh, you guys know each other. I said, not at all. I just met this guy at this squat rack. But he saw straight away that the vibe was there, and it felt like we'd known each other for a very long time. And for those of, you know, men who go to the gym, you can spend a lot of time talking to the same people over and over in the gym. You never know their name. My guy, bro, what's going on? You never exchange names. Benson was different. He introduced himself properly as a proud Ghanaian man, and we stuck up for a relationship. I think over time I came to know his spirit, his essence, and how it filled every room he walked into. And there are a few things that I will never forget about Benson. The first is that he will speak to anyone, and I think our interaction in the gym testifies that. And every time I introduced him to anyone, he always was comfortable, made him feel welcome. He also brought people together, and we were at an event one time at Google, and at the end of the event, they opened up the karaoke floor, and everyone stood around looking at each other, who's going to go first, who's going to go first. And then Benson looked at me and said, let's go. I was like, eh? He said, let's go, let's go. So then me thinking that he's going to put more money, more problems, something really easy for everyone to get to, maybe juicy. He puts on Usher Nice and Slow, and before I knew it, the two of us are duetting, body rolling, telling people it's 7 o'clock on the dot and we're in drop top. He made impact wherever he went. He came around 2020 to watch the Euro finals at my house. And after he passed, and people know I never post anything on my stories, but I posted Benson's because he wasn't like anyone else. And that treatment was different. People saw him on Twitter, they saw him on Instagram, and they all knew exactly who that was. No one was like, oh, faintly recognized, they knew that was the guy who came through the Euros, came through with the energy, the smiles, and everyone could engage with him, and they didn't forget him. He was also really consistent in everything he did. Whenever Benson greeted me, he always said, ah, Kwabna! And he always reminded me of how my aunties would greet me. And even at the hospice, when I came through, even like with barely any breath, ah, Kwabna! And at that moment, I knew that whatever happened, the light in Benson's eyes, the essence, the true being of who he was never gonna go away. Because that day, it was so painful to see him, but I was so reassured. I was so reassured in how he carried himself with such dignity. At a time where his body was failing him and things were falling apart, Benson still managed to hold together. And that fortitude and that sound of strength, I'll never forget. My dad's always told me that the measure of a man is the company he keeps, and I'm just so grateful that Benson and I were on the same team. Together with Michael, you know, three guys who had moved from Tottenham into the world of tech and navigated through many opportunities, but always did so with such dignity and grace, and you can tell by the way in which everyone here has spoken about him today. I moved from a position of like hopelessness and sadness to one of overwhelming gratitude, because whilst we grew up in the same area and he went to the same school as a lot of my friends in the school that my mom worked at, for many years Benson and I's paths didn't cross. Perhaps they didn't need to cross, but they did, and I'm forever grateful that it happened. I want to be able to say thank you to all of you for helping to contribute to who Benson is. I want to thank God for bringing Benson into my life. And if I can be so bold, I want to thank God on behalf of you guys also, because you are all here because in some way, shape or form, Benson touched your lives. He made an impact and he left you guys changed forever. So they say that the only way to really achieve immortality is to live a life worth remembering. And I can say with complete confidence that Benson's life will never be forgotten. And I'm glad I was able to witness a small part. So, Benson, KWAKU Dwumfour, KWAKU, MENSAH-BONSU, that year, in your memory, that year.
Thank you. My name is Michael. Thank you to his family for allowing me to speak. Benson is my eldest friend. I met him on the first day of year 7 at good old Tommy Moore. And I could not imagine the friendship that would develop. I've been fortunate to call Benson many names, many attachments through the years. Classmate, teammate, colleague, friend, brother. So no matter your attachment, whether he was your colleague, your friend, cousin, nephew, brother, son, we come together today, having laid Benson, our Benson, to rest. With the short time I have, I want to celebrate his life, and I can never fully put into words what it's meant for me to have called Benson a friend for over 20 years. There are so many aspects to the person Benson is, but I want to spend my time focusing on one in particular. When the news of his passing started to spread, I read all the beautiful tributes people are writing, remarking about his infectious energy, his smile, his passion, his competitiveness, his kindness, selflessness, insistence on excellence, business acumen, loved a bargain, the way he loved to laugh. But there was a particular word that every time I read, I smiled, because this word exemplifies who Benson was and the impact he had on everyone he met. And that word was light. Benson's light. I describe Benson as the brightest of the sun's rays made flesh by God. He greeted everyone with his light. He would do anything for anyone. It didn't matter if he had known you for 15 seconds or 15 years. He approached everyone the same. His light empowered, supported, and uplifted everyone he interacted with. His light drew people towards him. His light changed people's lives for the better. It made it so easy for people to love him. I struggle to speak of Benson in the past tense. Not because I'm in denial, but because I still feel his light with me. It will always be with me. Like I know it will still be with all of you and everyone who knows the power of his light. I have been made better through the warmth, selflessness, consistency, and purity of Benson's life. And I know I'm not alone. And before I end, I just want to thank Benson's family. His dad, his mom, his brothers, his sisters, the wider family, and anyone who had a hand in raising Benson. I want you all to know you raised an incredible human being. The best person. The best person I will ever know. The amount of people that showed up today is just a testament to the man you raised. On behalf of all his colleagues, his teammates, and friends, we are grateful to you, and we are forever grateful to Benson for being recipients to his light. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Okay, I just have an announcement. If your car is a Mini EN, registration number EN22DWO, EN22DWO, please kindly move your vehicle. You are blocking people from getting out. Thank you. So we have a tribute from a mighty giant of a human being at the moment. Let's give her encouragement. We have the goddaughter of Benson. Her name is Nova, and can we please encourage her as she comes up to lead the tribute? We can do better than that. Let's hear it for her.
To my godfather Benson, thank you for being the best godfather to me. You are the father I did not have. I will miss your kindness and your smile. I promise to remember every day how much you love me. And there was nothing in this world you wouldn't have gotten for me. I know I am blessed to have had you as a godfather. You are my gift from above, my protector. My God is born for Benson, love, Nova.
We can do better than that. Okay, so I've been told the food is ready, but culturally as Ghanaians, when we come to celebrate life, we have to open the floor. So for those of you who are not Ghanaian, we have to open the floor. So it's only fitting that I call mummy and daddy to come to the dance floor. Well, let's get the family members, the high table. Mommy and daddy will be supporting, of course, but culturally, we just want to open the dance floor just before we eat. So if I can have the DJ, please give us a befitting Ghanaian song, and then we can... What song do you want? Benz, okay, I'm gonna... Power, what song is that? EAW. DJ, did you give me a song before? Power. P-A-W-A, do you have that song? We wanna... Please, we're gonna get the song for you because we have to honor Benson. This is his celebration, so we wanna do that. So the song of Benson... I need help from Kojojo. We need to get this. Okay, he's gonna come, he's gonna get it for you. While we're gonna cue up the song, So not to waste time as we're gonna be getting the song queued up. Food is ready. We're gonna be calling people table by table. So while we're queuing up the song, we'll always start with a high table and then the people on the stage. So while we're queuing up the song to get everybody, you know, in a celebratory mood, even though this is all very bittersweet, I will be inviting people from the high table and this end to start going to take some food. And there's lots and lots of food, so just please be patient and bear with us. We will get to you.
So we're going to have the family up as those who are getting the food. I want to know. Thank you. Brother, I'm here. I am you, I do, I love you, I love you. Thank you. And I'm gonna be mixing and blending to the dancing pleasure. So make sure you get your dancing shoes ready. Also, the drinks are at the back. Those of you who haven't got any drinks or you still want some more drinks, yes, you can get the drinks. It's at the very back, or you can call for an assistance. The gents and ladies is at the entrance. If you just walk through the entrance there, you see the gents and ladies over there. So the music continues unabated. Soft tunes as we prepare ourselves for the second round. Powerful. Super, super occasion for a super, super, super fancy. Drink for yourself. Also, we have Sir Dave and Lady Ruth. They are the back there. If you want to give something to the family, you can see them. You see a lady and a gentleman seated at the very back. Yes, Sir Dave and Lady Ruth over there. Put your name down and a very, very big thank you will come your way. Yeah, so eating time, Chop time though, friends, as we fill our bellies to the maximum for the second round. Super, super dancing, touching coming your way very shortly.
Thank you. You know.
Okay, the queue is getting a bit short. So those of you who haven't got anything to eat, please make sure you join the queue and get some food before we run out. Okay, to all the guys in the house, every Tom, Dick and Harry, a special queue coming up. Kwaku from Bond, yes? And so please, we want every Tom, Dick and Harry on the dance floor. Every Tom, Dick and Harry. We want to make this occasion one of the best. Yes, so Kwaku from Bond coming just about now. DJs are ready, let's hit it. To all the guys, special request. Special request, Kwaku Frimpong, special request exclusively coming from myself, from Mami. We want to see all the guys, ladies and gents, on the dance floor. DJ, let's go. Once again, we want all the family members to join in. All the family members, Kwaku Frimpong. And they have requested it. Very cool free tone. Yes, you see, very cool free tone being accessible. Okay, so we want to see everybody on the dance floor, as we like to do it, right in the place to be. Style of the Torian Hall. Once again, in memory of Benson.
Hello? Sorry. Everybody that's here, you guys understand and know the kind of person Benson was. So when you hear a song like this, I expect everybody that's capable and able to get on the dance floor. Don't make me come and get you. Trust me, okay? So when we play this song, I need everybody that can dance to get to the dance floor, please, okay? I need everybody that can dance to get to the dance floor and dance in honor of my brother, okay?
Yeah, no, I'm not the fool, this what y'all been waiting for. When you find a trap, was on my disco. Real niggas in the trap, won't go tinko. No, y'all fake ass niggas want you toko. Ha, it's that second sermon brought to you by Red Blacko. Real trenches, baby, shoot out of Colo Buzongo. Tap in with a god body, Fico. Make it all together with a lot of shit, bad baby though. Yeah, y'all know I only fuck with that real shit. And you can tell y'all the corny ass rappers, they bring show ass rappers. Let's go.
Niggas in
the
trap,
we're
talking, I'm
Yeah, I wanna say don't believe I still can't believe. I got 1 minute till I can't believe. But I can't blame myself for this shit. No man that was born for this shit. Of course I fucked up. Who never fucked up has seen me here? No hands. Still I can't believe. She know what I mean. I was scared what you was bad for me. It is what it is. But I keep going now. More like a rolling stone. Cause I have no stopping time. Can't nobody stop a man. Oh, I keep going now. More like a rolling stone. Cause I have no stopping time. Can't nobody stop a man. No, I'm gonna run my race. I'm gonna keep my place. Cause I really have no one to play. When I fall again, I can't stand this pain. I can't watch me fail. So anytime you pray, remember my name. Remember you know a traveler.
I'm here standing different than I used to be. I just said she wanna flex on you. So I just need to get my money. If you fall in love, then it's a two. You go to bed first, I'm not happy. And you see drink cold, I'm not catchy. I'm not faking this, no fugazi. You see the 3 days, I'm not catchy. I'm not best and fit, I just want it.
If I broke my mind, it's messy. I'm not gonna go right. All I care for is life.
Because
Let me tell them how the thing goes. How the thing goes. Say bye. Use me, I go use my sense, my sense. I'm about to bash it. I need to go down, sense.